Today, we are making some vegan chicken pot pie, super comforting and super easy, so let's get it going. First, the chicken. I'll be using this stuff by Tofurky, which is perfect for something like this, but you could really use any vegan chicken you can find, such as these. You could even use soy curls if you want to, or just make a chickpea pot pie with some chickpeas. Lots of options. Now, let's prep our veggies. So we'll chop up around 5 to 6 carrots, as well as 5 to 6 stalks of celery. You can use an onion, but today I'll be using some shallots instead. So we're gonna go ahead and chop up 3 to 4 of those shallots. For the garlic, I'm gonna use this elephant garlic, which is aptly named. I mean, look at this thing. I feel like one clove of this is equal to a whole head of normal garlic. So I'm gonna chop up 1 clove, but I only ended up using about half of it. I would guess that's about 5 to 6 cloves of regular garlic. There you go, some chopped elephant garlic. And then next for our herbs, we're gonna gather and chop up about 1 to 2 teaspoons of some fresh thyme. And this is how I like to get the thyme leaves off. Just run your fingers along the stem until they'll pop right off. And then give those a quick choppity chop. And now some fresh sage, which we'll chop up. And I didn't end up using all of this sage, but again, I used about a heaping teaspoon or so. We're also gonna throw in an entire sprig of rosemary in there as well. For the top, we're gonna be lazy and use this accidentally plant-based puff pastry. There's other accidentally plant-based puff pastries and pie crusts out there, so just make sure to check the ingredients. And of course, you can make your own from scratch if you like, but I'm hungry now, so this will do. For the chicken, this is optional, but I'm gonna lightly brown mine just for the flavor. So get that chicken in there and cook it for about 8 minutes or so, or until you start to get spots that look like that. And then we're gonna set that aside, and now let's get a stew going. In a cast iron skillet, we're gonna add in 1/2 cup of unsalted vegan butter. I like to cube mine up so it melts a little faster. And once that's all melted, we'll add in our carrots, celery, and shallots. And we're just gonna stir those around and cook them over medium heat for about 8 to 10 minutes, or until they start to soften a bit. And then once we're happy with those, we're gonna throw in our thyme and sage, stir those around, and then add in some black pepper and a little bit of salt, followed by our garlic. Stir that around to get everyone to mingle together, and then toss in that rosemary sprig and also a couple of bay leaves. And we're gonna cook that down for 1 or 2 minutes, and then we'll start to add in 1/2 cup of flour, which we'll do in small increments. So pour in a bit, whisk it around, and once you don't see any dry flour, add some more and whisk it in, and repeat this process until all your flour has been incorporated. And cook that for 1 minute, and then we're gonna add in 2 cups of vegan chicken stock. And this is what I'm using. Make sure it's the vegan one, as the label for the non-vegan one looks very similar. You could also use something like this, which you can find online or at your local Asian market. You could also just use some veggie broth. Either way, let's slowly add in our stock and whisk it in, just like we did with the flour. And it's a bit challenging with all the veggies in there, but with some gumption, anything is possible. So just keep adding and whisking. And once all the stock is whisked in, we'll next add in 1 cup of non-dairy milk. And we'll do the same thing, adding a little at a time and whisking in between until it's all nice and mixed in. And then I tasted for seasoning and remembered I forgot to add in 1 tablespoon of this mushroom seasoning, which will impart a wonderful zap of umami. And you can also find this stuff online or at your local Asian market. I'll leave links in the description. And once we've tasted and adjusted for seasoning, let's add in the vegan chicken. And we're gonna stir that around, and then we'll add in about 1 heaping cup of some frozen peas. Stir that around as well, and at this point we can fish out the bay leaves and the rosemary sprig. And now it's time to get our puff pastry on top, and of course you can do whatever you like with this puff pastry, but I decided on making a little flower or sun pattern, depending on your interpretation, as this not only looks super cute, but it also increases the amount of edges on our crust, and thus we get more browning all around. So I unfolded the pastry and then sliced it into rectangular shapes. And after that, I simply arranged them like so, and I recommend placing them so there's a bit of a lip that extends up the wall of the skillet, as this will help ensure the filling doesn't boil over. And I'm also lightly pressing them into each other as well. And once we got all of our petals assembled, let's get the middle done. And for this, I got a bowl and just kind of cut around it. But honestly, I probably could have saved some time and just got a more perfect circle if I just cut it out with the bowl itself. But that's all right, it turned out great anyways. And then we'll lay that down, and I'll go ahead and lightly press it into the petals as well. And then I'll try and make a little crisscross section in the middle so that steam can escape, but I'll do a terrible job at it. And now we just need our vegan egg wash, and I'll be using this Just Egg, but I imagine you can use some aquafaba from a can of chickpeas or maybe just some melted vegan butter, but either way, let's get a pastry brush and get it all nice and coated. Next, we just gotta throw it in a preheated oven set to 425 degrees Fahrenheit for about 25 to 30 minutes or until the crust looks like that. And the hardest part of this recipe is not immediately cutting into it and eating it. Not only is it hotter than Hades, but you really need to let it set for a bit, so I recommend letting it cool for at least 15 minutes. And once that's done, we can cut out a portion. And another cool thing about this flower or sun pattern is it's a lot easier to cut out and portion, as you can see here. And I'm gonna go ahead and grab a pretty big slice because why not? And now it's time to eat. And I gotta say, this was so freaking good, so comforting and perfect for this time of year. That savory stew slash gravy, whatever you wanna call it, it's mixed with that vegan chicken and the veggies all baked in a buttery, flaky crust. It's just perfect. And this is totally ideal for a family, but honestly, I've been subsisting on this for the past couple of days and I'm not even close to getting tired of it. So go ahead and eat the whole thing yourself. And when you're done with that, go ahead and make some chicken fried steak. There's a video link right there. If you do make this, let me know how it goes. I hope you're all doing great, and I'll see you next time.